Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and I want to talk about some look-alike plants here, just a little bit. I want to get in close on this one here, and we're going to do just a little bit of driving around here and looking at some plants, and then I want to explain what we're dealing with here. All right? Okay, now let's take a look at this one down here. We have a very, very similar leaf structure on this one down here. Very similar indeed. Okay, now I'm going to go back to the other one. Let's see, here's another one of these with a very similar leaf structure. And then this one right here, this is the one we're worried about. You see that leaf structure? Very similar. Very similar. We do not want to get these mixed up. I'll explain why. See? Very similar. Idea how prolific this thing is. It's all over around my stairs here. All over my front yard. All over where I harvest my feed for my rabbits. And here's the third choice right here. Look carefully. This is one you probably know and recognize. Look at the leaf structure. Very similar. Very similar. There's a nice leaf down there. Very, very similar. I had to drive about a quarter of a mile to find this one so we could look at it. You look at it very carefully now. Okay, I'm not going to walk through the poison ivy in my bare feet for this one, but let's zoom in on it. There we go. There's another one right there. There it is. Follow the stem down. And there she is. Okay. All right, here's another close one. Now I want you to look at this very carefully because this is Queen Anne's lace, or wild carrot. And I want you to notice that these little flowerlets are very close together. Right in the middle, there's a little purple dark dot. That's another flower head right dead center in the middle. It has a leaf that is very similar to the other two we were looking at. And of the other two, one of them is fine and the other one may very well be deadly poisonous. Okay, Queen Anne's lace, wild carrot. Now some of the books that I've read say that this particular plant may also be cause dermatitis or something in some people, but I've been around this stuff since I was a little kid. We picked these things and played with them and they smell good and all kinds of stuff. I've never had any adverse reactions to it. I have indeed yanked some of them out of the ground and tried to cook the carrots. They would be edible, but they are most assuredly not palatable and tougher than tripe. I mean, I don't know how you'd ever get any kind of sustenance out of them. But that is it. That is Queen Anne's lace or wild carrot. Okay. Down here in the bottom we have some horse nettle growing down there. We've talked about horse nettle in the past, but this one, Queen Anne's lace. All right, let's go look at the other two. One of them happens to be right next door. Remember this one? Looks very similar. Very similar. What could that very similar thing be? Well, that very similar thing growing right in amongst another carrot. Here's another carrot right here. This is just common old everyday ragweed. There's common ragweed. Here's another one right here. There's common ragweed and there's giant ragweed. I don't know if they're related to each other or not, but as you can see, the leaves look very similar to the Queen Anne's lace leaf. It is safe. It is good to feed your rabbits, has high protein, lots of fiber. They love it. Queen Anne's lace, safe. Feed it to your rabbits. Now let's go find that other one, and I'll show you the one that's not safe.
Okay, I know this is not part of the topic at hand, but you see that funny colored, olive colored bush there? That is wild asparagus. Grows all over Michigan. I grew up with that stuff. Those little bitty beads on there are the berries. That is indeed wild asparagus. If you see a fuzzy looking plant like that on the side of the road, mark it, because next spring, you're gonna have asparagus coming up right there. And there's your other plant right there, growing right there in that fence row. Take a look at it carefully. Has a head very, very similar to the Queen Anne's lace. It's a little bit more open in nature. You look down, it's growing around a type of lettuce or thistle of some kind. But my goodness, that looks very similar. Very similar. And here's another little one down front. We'll go back over to the house. We'll get some looks at some closer ones. What is that thing? This is ragweed. I don't have any Queen Anne's lace here. This is ragweed. Ragweed, safe. This plant here, with the little flowers on the top that are separated but similar to that Queen Anne's lace, that looks like maybe it's just a little anemic for a Queen Anne's lace, with a very similar leaf structure with no fur on it, is called hemlock. And I've got lots of it here. I've been trying to eradicate it because it indeed is poisonous. It's a neurotoxin. If ingested, it can kill you. You don't want this mixed in the feed with your animals. You really don't want it in your fields with your animals. Hemlock. That's all I got for right now. Ken Bacon. Bye for now.